Hello children, I am Azizani from Sir Isaac Newton School. I hope you all are safe and today we are going to continue our lesson for grade 4 CBSE. In our previous class we have discussed about shapes around us. In that topic we particularly discussed about polygons, right? Okay, and today we are going to continue the lesson. And today we are going to discuss about circle. Okay, do you know circle? Do you know how to draw a circle? Yeah, usually you used to draw it by your bangles or round circle shaped materials, right? But today we are going to learn what is a circle and how to draw a circle using your pencil and compass. Okay, a circle is a closed shape made of curved lines. In polygons we have learned we can draw a polygon using our straight lines, right? Using a straight lines. But in circle we have to use only curved lines. For a circle we have to use only curved lines. Okay, each point on the circle is at same distance from the middle point. So this is a circle, right? In a roti or dosa, all points on the outline are at the same distance from the fire, which means this is a dosa, right? Okay, we are making it in a round shape pan. Okay, now the fire is only at the center. Is that right or not? Yeah, the fire is only at the center. But we are making a big dosa. But how it's getting cooked in all the sides? The fire is at the center only. But how the full dosa is getting cooked evenly? Yeah. So this is the definition for a circle, which is all the points in the outline are at an equal distance from the fire and get crisp at the same time, which means the same for a circle. A circle is a closed shape made of curved lines. Already I told you, a circle is a closed shape made of curved lines. A polygon is a closed shape made of straight lines. And here, a circle is a closed shape made of curved lines. So each point on the circle is at the same distance from the middle point. So from the middle point, all this distance is same. So from this middle point the distance is same for all the sides, right? Okay, next, now we are going to learn how to draw a circle using two pencils and a piece of string. Okay, two pencils and a piece of string. Now take two pencils and a piece of string. First, attach two pencils to the ends of the piece of string. So you have to tie both the pencils using your string. Now hold one pencil firmly on the point marked O. So place and hold one pencil in a particular point which can be marked as O, and extend the string and hold the other pencil. Now extend the string and hold the other pencil. Now keeping the pencil fixed at O, you should not move this pencil, right? You have to keep this at the center which is marked as O, and you have to move the other pencil. Now you have to move the other pencil around till you form a circle. So you have to move this pencil like this to form a circle, right? See here, one pencil is at the center which is marked as O, and the other is extended, and now we are going to move the other pencil to form a circle. Cut out the circle. Now fold a small portion of the circle and unfold it. Now I have drawn the circle and cut it out from the full paper, and now we are going to fold this. And after that, after making a line, just unfold it. Okay, the crease formed touches the circle at two different points, right? The crease, the line which is formed, is touching the two different points in a circle, right? So here and here, this is touching a two different points. Such a line with its ends on a circle is called a chords. What is this? Chords. Chords on the same circle can have different lengths. So the length of this chord is different from length of this chord. If I fold it evenly, then this, the length of this chord will be different from this chord, right? Okay. Next, fold the circle you made in hands. You made a circle by using two pencils and a string, right? Cut it out from the paper and now fold it half and again half. So you will have four quarter sides, right? The creases are bigger this time and meet in the middle. See, we made two creases. So they are meeting at the point which we are going to mark it as O. Place a dot there and mark it as O. So it is O, right? Okay. All points of a circle are at an equal distance from O. Now this is O, right? Okay. Now you can measure the distance of this, or this creases. You can measure the lengths of this creases. So what will you get? Yeah, all points of a circle are at an equal distance from O. So from here, the length of this creases will be same, right? So we call O as the center of the circle. So that we are calling this point, which we marked as O, right? So this is called a center of the circle. This is called a center of the circle. The chords. Chord means this line, right? So the chord that passes through the center of a circle is called the diameter of the circle. Today we are going to learn diameter and radius. Okay, first we will discuss about diameter. Diameter is nothing but the length of the circle which crosses through the center point. This is called a center of the circle. The chord that passes through the center of a circle, the line which the chord which passes through the center of the circle is called a diameter of the circle. Right? Okay. Now you can draw a circle, right? You can draw a circle using your two pencils and a string and fold it evenly to get a middle point. After that, draw a straight line and measure it. It is called the diameter of the circle. And also chord of the circle. Chord means what? You can fold it anywhere, right? You can draw a line anywhere. So you can draw a line anywhere, here or here or anywhere. So measure the length of the chord also. Okay, see, all diameters of a circle are equal. The diameter is the longest chord in a circle. So all the diameters of a circle are equal, right? So the diameter is the longest chord in a circle. Next, a line from the center of a circle to a point on the outline is called the radius. A line from the center of a circle. So this is a center of the circle, right? So from here to outline of the circle. From the center point to outline of the circle is called the radius. Is called the radius. The plural of radius is radii. The plural of radius is radii. The plural of radius is radii. The radius of the given circle is 2. If the radius of the given circle is 2, what will be its diameter? Yeah, it's 4. The half of the diameter is called the radius, which means if we measure the full length of the circle through the center of the circle is called diameter, and from the center of the circle to the outline of the circle is called a radius. So a radius tells us how big the circle is. The longer the radius, the bigger the circle. If the radius of the circle is longer, then the circle will be a bigger one. If the radius is a smaller one, then the circle will be the smaller circle. Okay. Now measure the length of the rope that Jack and Jegan are tied with from the center. So this is the center and Jegan is tied here and Jack is tied here. Now you have to measure the length of the Jack's ropes and length of Jegan's rope. Who can eat more grass? Okay. If you have your book with you, then try this with your pencil. Please use your pencil to measure the answer. If you don't have your book, means you just draw a circle by yourself and try to answer these questions. Next, a compass is used to draw circles accurately. First, we have learned how to draw a circle using two pencils and a string, right? Now, we are going to learn how to draw a circle using your compass and pencil. So, follow the steps given to construct a circle using a compass. So, step 1. First, we have to take a compass and a pencil. Next, we have to insert the pencil into the holder. First, we have to take a compass and a pencil. And then we have to insert the pencil into the holder. Now we have to insert this pencil into a holder. The pencil tip should be in line with the tip of the needle. So the pencil's tip should be at the equal length with the needle. Move the legs of the compass away from each other. So if you want a small circle, then the distance should be small. If you want a bigger circle, then move the legs of the compass away from each other. So place the needle point on the paper. Now you have to place the needle point on the paper. See here, you have to place the needle point on the paper. This should not be lifted till you have finished drawing. Till you finished your circle, you should not lift the tip of the needle from your paper. Okay. Next, place the pencil tip on the paper and rotate your wrist to draw the circle. Now rotate your wrist to draw the circle. Okay. Okay, children, today's exercise for you is draw a smaller circle and a bigger circle using your pencil and compass and send it to your WhatsApp group. Thank you.